Okay, the question of the day is, does size matter?
Hell nah, size doesn't matter, man.
You don't want to pull up with some duty galley 3-incher, because we don't like that shit.
Oh, fuck yeah, the latest guy I had, he really fucking jacked the beanstalk, and let me tell you, I was so happy. Oh my god.
All about the motion of the ocean. My boyfriend does have a big dick, though.
So, genuinely, when I'm down the pub with my mates, right, we don't make the kind of comments like Rebekah Vardy made, for example, about Peter Andre's manhood, which I'm sure is of a completely normal size. The idea of a man having his manhood dug out massively in the press can be very, very damaging, can't it?
He was like, can you imagine? I was just sitting at home with my wife and my kids and my phone started pinging. And the next thing you know, not only is he trending, he's trending because she said he had, you know, a Chipolata.
Asking for a friend, obviously. You know, do men with a smaller size manhood have that much to worry about, really? Would you, women care that much about it?
No.
Fair enough. That's good. Andre will be pleased. Right.
I'm just going to put it out. 15 years this has been going on, and I let everyone have their laugh, and I've been the butt of all jokes. I've took it for 15 years, and then it's brought up in court that goes to a lot more than 4 million people, and I've been laughing about it for a while, but yes, I think we all know now it was just a made-up story, fine, but it's a little more serious than that.
This is a tale of a famous penis that's been captivating the nation for decades. Peter Andre's penis at the headlines again during the Wagafa Christie libel trial. Rebekah Vardy had fucked Peter some years earlier and described his penis as a miniature Chipolata. Peter's Paul Lizzie Cunt came to his defense stating she'd seen him in his speeders and there was no way he had a Chipolata. Peter found it hard to keep biting his lip over the small penis allegations. Miss Vardy was forced to admit she lied about his penis. There were calls to give the guy a fucking break. Peter wasn't keen on being made to look like a ladies' man either. He hit back at Becky, declaring she must be shitting bit because he couldn't remember shit. Despite the humiliation of being called out for having a small dick, Peter managed to joke about it with a cheeky insta-post. Peter's lovely wife, Emily, came to his rescue saying she loved his, quote, massive willy, unquote.
So we're gonna cut it into squares that basically, they depend on the size of the sausage. Stop looking at me out the corner of my eye. So wait.
He tried to make a joke of the situation during a sexy calendar shoot where he claimed to put a sock down his undies to make it look bigger. He also used the sock trick to make his dick look bigger than some geezer called Mark Wright. He also said he'd never need a new dating website which catered for men with small wallets.
Mysterious girl, I wanna get close to you. Baby girl, I said tonight is your lucky night. Peter Andre along with my blood runs falling behind.
I stop and stare at you, walking on the shore. I try to concentrate, my mind wants to explore. The tropical scent of you takes me up above.
Peter has always stood up for the size of his member. He previously boasted that his penis was the size of his 8-inch tele remote. His then wife Katie Price backed him up in his claim. But when did all this shit about Peter's toddler begin? And who the fuck is Katie Price?
It's a world away from what they're used to, but for the next 2 weeks, it'll be home sweet home.
I'm a celebrity! Get me out of here!
Thank you. You like my titties and they like my ass.
I love you, mate. Would you grab a picture of Katie? What would it be? Her ass, her ass. I've done your boobs, Katie. I've felt every part of them. So.
It's basically a bimbo, you know?
How do you not topple over? Honestly, you are a balancing act. Bar none. Doesn't that hurt your spine? No?
Well, what do you want to do?
Let's shag. No, just joking.
Come on, Geordie, tell us a story.
I goes by much solid. I hunger for your touch. Still my
Did it make you go, I need your love,
I need your love,
girl, I wanna do to you all the things you want me to.
After the jungle, Pete and Katie wasted no time in getting to know each other better. Katie documented the highly charged event in her autobiography. She wanted him inside her real, real bad. Katie described Pete's number as a huge cop, contradicting Rebekah Vardy's Chipolata account. After the sweet test couple there who lied, they passed out a tad sweaty.
You smash it? There's no denying that. The fact is, I'm a single guy, I'm young, you know.
You definitely smash it.
Fucking hell, fuck off.
Katie has made a habit of discussing her past lover's members. Check this shit out. Dane's tiger was Minnie's coat. I couldn't feel shit. Once you've had black, you don't go back. But I sure did. The most disturbing porn you could think of, times by 10. Getting fucked by your husband dressed up as a woman ain't all that. He was so big it hurt to piss. If someone has got a big dick, it sure hurts. Danny was laying downstairs, so I nicknamed him Danny Chipolate. I could only get Karen's tip from there. Chris is ginger, so he's got a big dick. Carl's the biggest I've ever had, and that's a fact, motherfucker. Well, Carl sure is the cat that got the cream.
Damn, motherfucker, I ate everything. I ate the pussy, I ate the butt, I ate every motherfucking thing.
Sorry, did I break your concentration?
Kiss my ass, brotherfucker.
Fucking calm down, alright?
As for you, you fucking slut, if you're back to suck his cock, you fucked my pussy this morning, so enjoy tasting my pussy. Champagne fisting, fucking. I've done it all, of course I did.
Get up, get up, get busy, do it. Get up, 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 get up,
you never forced just by checking the record you bought. Over and on again, get with it and do that thing. Get up, get up, get busy, do it, get up and move that body. Get up, people, now get down to it,
for the night is over.
Get up, get busy, do it, I wanna see you party. Get up, people, now get down to it,
for the night is over.
Mrs. Andre, that's the first time I've heard that.
Do you wanna know why? I get so much stick about my singing when I know I can sing.
A whole new world,
a new fantastic point of view.
No one to tell us no, or where to go.
If someone says something horrible to Harvey, what does Harvey say?
Hello, you can.
Harvey. Okay,
Harvey Price, ladies and gentlemen, what a fucking legend.
Okay, can we, I'd rather just stop this, that's fine.
You want to stop?
Yeah.
Hey.